translation of Sahih Bukhari, Book 79. Expiation for Unfulfilled Oaths. Volume 8, Book 79, Number 699. Narrated Kab bin Wujra. I came to the Prophet and he said to me, "Come near." So I went near to him and he said, "Are your lice troubling you?" I replied, "Yes." He said, "Shave your head and make expiation in the form of fasting, sadaqah, that is giving in charity, or offering a sacrifice." The sub-narrator Ayub said, "Fasting should be for 3 days, and the nusuk, that is sacrifice, is to be a sheep, and the sadaqah is to be given to 6 poor persons." Number 700. Narrated Abu Huraira. A man came to the Prophet and said, "I am ruined." The Prophet said, "What is the matter with you?" He said, "I had sexual relation with my wife while I was fasting in Ramadan." The Prophet said, "Have you got enough to manumit a slave?" He said, "No." The Prophet said, "Can you fast for 2 successive months?" The man said, "No." The Prophet said, "Can you feed 60 poor persons?" The man said, "No." Then the Prophet said to him, "Sit down," and he sat down. Afterwards an irk, that is, a big basket containing dates, was brought to the Prophet and the Prophet said to him, "Take this and give it in charity." The man said, "To poorer people than we?" On that, the Prophet smiled till his premolar teeth became visible, and then told him, "Feed your family with it." See Hadith number 157, Volume 3. Number 701. Narrated Abu Huraira. A man came to Allah's Apostle and said, "I am ruined." The Prophet said to him, "What is the matter?" He said, "I have done a sexual relation with my wife while fasting in Ramadan." The Prophet said to him, "Can you afford to manumit a slave?" He said, "No." The Prophet said, "Can you fast for 2 successive months?" He said, "No." The Prophet said, "Can you feed 60 poor persons?" He said, "No." Then an Ansari man came with an irk, a big basket full of dates. The Prophet said to the man, "Take this basket and give it in charity." That man said, "To poorer people than we, O Allah's Apostle? By him who has sent you with the truth. There is no house in between the 2 mountains of the city of Medina poorer than we." So the Prophet said to him, "Go and feed it to your family." Number 702. Number 703. Narrated Al-Juwayd bin Abdurrahman. As'ab bin Yazid said, "The saw at the time of the Prophet was equal to 1 mud plus 1/3 of a mud of your time, and then it was increased in the time of Caliph Umar bin Abdulaziz." Number 704. Narrated Nafi. Ibn Umar used to give the zakat of Ramadan zakat al-fitr according to the mud of the Prophet, the first mud, and he also used to give things for expiation for oaths according to the mud of the Prophet. Abu Qutaybah said, "Malik said to us, 'Our mud, that is, of Medina, is better than yours, and we do not see any superiority except in the mud of the Prophet.'" Malik further said to me, "If a ruler came to you and fixed a mud smaller than the one of the Prophet, by what mud would you measure what you give for expiation or zakat al-fitr?" I replied, "We would give it according to the mud of the Prophet." On that, Malik said, "Then, don't you see that we have to revert to the mud of the Prophet ultimately?" Number 705. Narrated Anas bin Malik. Allah's Apostle said, "O Allah, bestow your blessings on their measures, saw and mud, that is, of the people of Medina." Number 706. Narrated Abu Huraira. The Prophet said, "If somebody manumits a Muslim slave, Allah will save from the fire every part of his body for freeing the corresponding parts of the slave's body. Even his private parts will be saved from the fire because of freeing the slave's private parts." Number 708. Narrated Aisha. That she intended to buy Barira, a slave girl, and her masters stipulated that they would have her wallah. When Aisha mentioned that to the Prophet, he said, "Buy her, for the wallah is for the one who manumits." Number 709. Narrated Abu Musa al-Ash'ari. I went to Allah's Apostle along with a group of people from the tribe of al-Ash'ari, asking for mounts. The Prophet said, "By Allah, I will not give you anything to ride, and I have nothing to mount you on." We stayed there as long as Allah wished, and after that, some camels were brought to the Prophet and he ordered that we be given 3 camels. When we set out, some of us said to others, Allah will not bless us, as we all went to Allah's apostle asking him for mounts, and although he had sworn that he would not give us mounts, he did give us. So we returned to the Prophet and mentioned that to him. He said, I have not provided you with mounts, but Allah has. By Allah, Allah willing, if I ever take an oath, and then see that another is better than the first, I make expiration for my dissolved oath, and do what is better and make expiration. Number 710 Narrated Hamad. The same narration above it is 709, I make expiation for my dissolved oath, and I do what is better, or do what is better and make expiation. Number 711 Narrated Abu Huraira. The Prophet Solomon said, Tonight I will sleep with my 90 wives, each of whom will get a male child who will fight for Allah's cause. On that, his companion Sufyan said that his companion was an angel said to him, Say, if Allah will Allah willing, but Solomon forgot to say it, he slept with all his wives, but none of the women gave birth to a child, except one who gave birth to a half-boy. Abu Hurairah added, The Prophet said, If Solomon had said, If Allah will Allah willing, he would not have been unsuccessful in his action, and would have attained what he had desired. Once Abu Hurairah added, Allah Apostle said, If he had accepted. Number 712 Narrated Zadam al-Jarmi. We were sitting with Abu Musa al-Ash'ari, and as there were ties of friendship and mutual favors between us and his tribe, his meal was presented before him and there was chicken meat in it. Among those who were present there was a man from Bani Ta'amilu having a red complexion as a non-Arab freed slave, and that man did not approach the meal. Abu Musa said to him, Come along. I have seen Allah's apostle eating of that is, chicken. The man said, I have seen a chicken's eating something I regarded as dirty, and so I have taken an oath that I shall not eat its meat chicken. Abu Musa said, Come along. I will inform you about it that is, your oath. Once we went to Allah's apostle in company with a group of Asharian, asking him for mounts while he was distributing some camels from the camels of Zakat. Ayub said, I think he said that the Prophet was in an angry mood at the time. The Prophet said, By Allah, I will not give you mounts, and I have nothing to mount you on. After we had left, some camels of booty were brought to Allah's apostle and he said, Where are those Ash'ariyan? Where are those Ash'ariyan? So we went to him and he gave us 5 very fat good-looking camels. We mounted them and went away, and then I said to my companions, We went to Allah's apostle to give us mounts, but he took an oath that he would not give us mounts, and then later on he sent for us and gave us mounts. Perhaps Allah's apostle forgot his oath. By Allah, we will never be successful, for we have taken advantage of the fact that Allah's apostle forgot to fulfill his oath. So let us return to Allah's apostle to remind him of his oath. We returned and said, O Allah's apostle, we came to you and asked you for mounts, but you took an oath that you would not give us mounts but later on you gave us mounts, and we thought or considered that you have forgotten your oath. The Prophet said, Depart, for Allah has given you mounts. By Allah, Allah willing, if I take an oath and then later find another thing better than that, I do what is better, and make expiation for the oath. Number 715 Narrated Abdurrahman bin Samura. Allah's Apostle said, O Abdurrahman, do not seek to be a ruler, for, if you are given the authority of ruling without your asking for it, then Allah will help you. But if you are given it by your asking, then you will be held responsible for it, that is, Allah will not help you, and if you take an oath to do something and later on find another thing, better than that, then do what is better and make expiation for the dissolution of your oath.